This is the SAP Developer News for March 7th, 2024.
Hola, SAP developers. In case you missed it, the SAP BTP solution diagrams were recently updated. We got new icons and an updated guideline. Previously, the diagrams and icons were only available as PowerPoint assets. Now, they are available as libraries for draw.io, meaning that creating diagrams will now be much easier. So apart from the draw.io libraries, the icons are also available as SVG files. They are all available on GitHub, where you can also find some example diagrams that can help you get started. So go ahead and get familiar with the updated guidelines, download the starter kit, and start using the new assets in draw.io. Also, in case you would like to build your diagrams programmatically, I recently updated the diagrams Python library fork to include the new SAP BTP solution icons. I've also submitted a PR to the main diagrams repo, so I hope that sooner rather than later, they will be available in the standard diagrams Python library. And before I finish, I want to remind you about the developer challenges in SAP community. I hope you enjoyed last month's dev challenge that focused on CAP plugins. Now this week, we're kicking off March developer challenge, focusing on cloud events and event-driven architectures. Make sure to check it out. I'm including the links in the description below.
Did you know the Database Explorer in SAP HANA Cloud offers a preview of the spatial data? As a multimodal database, SAP HANA can store, access, and process different types of data, including spatial. This is data that describes the position, shape, and orientation of objects and is represented as geometries in the form of points, strings, or polygons. In the result table, select the binary values of the spatial data that you want to visualize, right-click the highlighted cell, and select View Spatial Data. Selecting cells in multiple rows will display all selected spatial data on the same map.
Hello everyone! February release of Cloud Application Programming Model is now available. It is remarkable to see significant new features and capabilities getting added every month. We have some information about support and feature requests for CAP plugins. A common CDS definition for time zones is provided that is useful as a code list. The open source CDS plugin for audit logging is now generally available. Then we have updates for CAP Java, namely optimistic logging API that can be called from custom code, out-of-the-box support for automatic tracking of changes, and support for generic outbox. Finally, we have updates from tools where we have new snippet for annotate statements. There is support for a new command in the CDS add to add HTML5 application repository. There are new convenience options for CDS bind command. The service keys are now automatically created with this command. In addition, CDS bind comes with a new two app services option that binds to all services of a given Cloud Foundry application. You can now upgrade all tenants at once via the CDS MTX CLI. Starting with the version 7.6.0 of CDS and CDS DK, CAP plugins can now contribute a schema for their configuration. CDS build now allows the implementation of custom build plugins. To know more about these updates, please visit the CAPIA documentation page. Links can be found in the description below. And if you have just embarked on your CAP journey or you want to learn more, I recommend you to follow the link to the ongoing Back to Basic YouTube series by DJ Adams. That can be found on the top of the CAPIA documentation.
As in many projects, the volume of use case ideas for consideration quickly grows from a few to a dozen to hundreds. For IT teams responsible for governing the use of SAP Build, they will need to manage ideation and use case selection at scale. They can do this now with the Use Case Buddy, which was released this week. Check out the first link below to the launch blog post. But let me tell you about the Use Case Buddy. It's a digital assistant to collect, analyze, score, and submit and review use case ideas for prioritization and development approval based on their complexity. It consists of an app based on SAP Build Apps, an automated workflow based on SAP Build Process Automation, and a repository page in SAP Build Workzone Advanced Edition. It's packaged as a set of templates that you can download, then customize and brand for your own organization. So you can use the templates to build the solution, then host it in your organization's landscape for internal use. There's a tutorial group for SAP BTP admins or Center of Excellence teams who are responsible for managing the pipeline of low-code use cases and low-code solution portfolios. The link is also below. Happy building.
The SAP Business Application Studio is a great leveler. It's available to anyone, even with just a trial account with only a browser. And the team keep on rolling out those updates. Here's a few highlights from the February 2024 edition. They've improved the startup time for dev spaces. It's now easier and quicker to get back to your code after a session timeout. There's also a new command bar that has all the common actions. And last but not least, there's a new data center in Switzerland that hosts the Business Application Studio. What's not to like? And before I end this very quick item, did you know that some of the tooling in the Business Application Studio dev spaces is actually open source? I only found this out the other day when I was directed to a pull request in a public repo on GitHub. To find out more about the updates, head over to the blog post, and to find out more about the open source tooling, head over to the GitHub repo. Links in the description.
One of the major benefits of cloud computing in general is that it's so easy, cheap, and dynamic to allocate hardware underneath our systems and services. This is a major benefit that now comes to the ABAP cloud on SAP BTP environment. With release 2402, we see the introduction of elastic scaling. A system can be configured to dynamically add or remove application servers depending upon the load on that system. And it all works within your pre-configured parameters. So check out the blog post by Frank Jens to go through all the details of how to turn on this feature, configure, and monitor it to get the best use out of your ABAP cloud environment.
This week, during the major annual event SAP Data Unleashed, our company announced some great new features coming soon to SAP Analytics Cloud and SAP DataSphere. Let me summarize the top 5 announcements for you. First, Joule will be integrated into SAP Analytics Cloud. This will introduce business AI capabilities, enabling users to request new reports or modify their planning scenarios using natural language. Second, SAP DataSphere will introduce a knowledge graph feature, facilitating the discovery of new insights and patterns across systems. Third, the integration between SAP DataSphere and SAP Analytics Cloud will be strengthened to support analytics and cross-organizational planning scenarios more effectively. Fourth, the SAP Analytics Cloud Compass will enhance scenario planning with SAP Analytics Cloud. This feature allows for generation of various scenarios, such as inflation rates, using Monte Carlo simulation and provide simulated probabilities of impact on profit. And fifth, there will be an increased collaboration with Calibra to integrate the Calibra AI governance platform with SAP solutions. You can find additional resources in the description of this episode.